Always try to buy scallops that are actually in their shell, because it's a great guarantee to how fresh they are. Now, to open up a scallop, it's quite easy. You get your knife and you push that through that tiny little gap and just twist. And once you've opened the shell, get the top of the knife and just slide against the top of the shell. And look what happens. The shell comes up. There you go. Now, the only piece of the scallop we're interested in is this white part here. Slide your thumb down the muscle and pop it out of its skirt. This orange beak, the coral it's called, I don't really like cooking with them because they taste of nothing and they get very rubbery. It's not worth it. Get rid of the orange part and just cook that nice white pearl. The easiest way to cut a scallop in half is look at this flat bit here and then just find out halfway. And what that does, if you're halfway there, it cuts the scallop exactly into half. Look how fresh they are. They're still moving. They're still pulsating. That's the only way to eat scallops. Open up in your hand like that.
Yep.
Yeah? And then in the seasoning here, we've got half curry powder, half salt. And when you season, always season from a height so it spreads across it.
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's go. Four scallops into the pan. Scallops in, 12 o'clock. That's it, there you go. By the time we get down to 6 o'clock, we know exactly where to turn the scallop. Okay, off the heat, watch, and turn.
Yes, sir.
Good. Look how fresh these scallops are, let's go. And less olive oil in there next time, yeah? What you're doing now, Tam, is you're actually boiling the scallop as opposed to soaking it, okay?
Yes, chef.
Yeah? Back on the heat, come on. You're losing the heat in the pan. Right, stop. Stop, stop, stop. Tell me the difference between those scallops and those scallops.
They're less cooked than those.
Come on, then. I want them starting again. Get them in the bin and start again. I can't serve two portions nicely done and two portions that have been boiled. Now, turn around and work together a little bit,
chef.
Yes? Take your time.
I'm serving the scallops on a delicious cauliflower puree.
Now, cook them in butter for about 2 to 3 minutes until they go nice and soft, and then we're going to add some milk. And what the milk does, it actually helps keep the puree really nice and vibrant white. Now, as that milk starts to boil, we're going to finish it with a touch of cream. And now we're going to cook that out about another 3 or 4 minutes, and then puree. It's really important to blend this when it's really nice and hot, so therefore, the hotter it is, the finer it becomes. If you leave it to cool down, then you'll get lumps through it, so make sure that you always blend it when it's hot. OK. Now, look what's inside. This really nice, rich, creamy, smooth cauliflower puree. That will beat cauliflower and cheese any day. How many scallops you got per portion?
6 per portion,
OK,
chef.
Good. Watch. Watch me. Cauliflower puree on. Then the cape of raisin vinaigrette. Watch. It's very strong. Yeah, it's very tasty. It's very tangy. Now we get the sweetness of the scallops on there, on top of the cauliflower puree.
Presentation is crucial. The less elements in a dish, the more important it is to plate it upright.
Right, stop. Stop there. OK. You're not listening to me. You're going around the outside of the plate again. Yeah? There you put them on. The scallops sit on top of the cauliflower puree. Let's start again. Yeah? Third time lucky. I want you to really think about how much money we're wasting. And I want you, seriously, to wake up and get a grip. This is the same table we're doing for the third time, yes?
Yes, chef.
If this doesn't go out properly, one of you are going home. Don't worry about waiting till later. Oil in the pan, let's go. Dear, oh dear. Just drizzle that round there like that. Now, look at yours and look at mine. Tell me the difference. You've gone out round the rim of the plate. Customers don't want to eat off the rim of the plate. You come in. Next time, get it right, OK? Clean the plate, let's go.